Here I am in the time data selection worksheet of LMS Test Lab. If I look in Data Explorer, I have got some data, time histories, in my input basket, which I want to process. So I have them in the input basket. I hit replace, and now I have my time histories. I can view them by clicking here. And I can look at the different channels. When I have a channel showing in the top here, there's an overview, and down below there's a blue bar that I can move around to look at and interrogate the time files. I can scroll through them. I can also look at multiple time files if I would like at the same time. Right now I'm going to do some calculations or want to do some calculations. So I'm going to the Tools, Add-ins, and I'm going to select an add-in called Time Signal Calculator. If you have tokens, this only requires 26 tokens and allows you to do manipulation to these time files. So let's start with something simple. Here I have channel 5 and channel 6, two different vibration channels. Maybe I want to sum those together. I can say channel 5 plus channel 6. I'm going to call that a sum. I hit calculate, and now I have the sum of channel 5 and channel 6. It put it in this new ID, channel 7. If I click on that, I can see channel 7. That is the sum of 5 and 6. It's orange rather than green because it's not fully stored yet. So I can look at it, decide if I want it. If I like it, I can hit save as to store this to a new file, or I can hit the save button to save to an existing file. So that's nice. Now let's do something else. We're going to add the same channels together, but this time we will use the channel name rather than the channel number. And I'll call this sum number 2. I hit calculate, and notice I get the exact same result for both channels. The advantage of using a channel name rather than a channel number is that I can store away these formulas and I can reload them to analyze other data sets. And if this other data set, if I use consistent names, I don't have to worry about the channel number by using the names. Or alternatively, I can use the channel number or a combination thereof in these formulas. I want to do one other thing. I want to maybe multiply this data. I have to correct it. Maybe had a bad cal factor. So I'm going to do multiply by 100 on oil pan. And when I'm doing this, I can use parentheses and other types of orders of operation. I can assign this, for example, a new unit for one. So when it gets multiplied, it'll be in units of G's. I can type in I want the new ID to be correction. I hit calculate, and now I have the corrected data. So that's another thing I can do. In fact, if I was very confident, I could even set the destination ID to be the same as the original channel, and it would store it back on top of the original channel until I hit save. Okay, so there we had three formulas that we wrote, but there's other types of formulas that are possible. Here I have the formula field, and there's this FX button here. And here are a lot of different types of formulas we can use. Signal generators, filtering, drift correction, integration, differentiation, PWM analysis. I'm going to do some filtering. I'm going to pick filter low pass because I want to get rid of some high frequency content on my channels. Again, I'll do the oil pan. So I'll say channel 5, I want to low pass filter, keep everything below 500 hertz. I'll use a Butterworth filter. I can look at that filter shape. Maybe I think, oh, that's a pretty sharp filter. I can change the order of the filter to be something more gradual if I would like. I hit OK. This is going to be my filtered data. I hit calculate, and now I have filtered data. So I can look at that versus the original oil pan data that I analyzed. And I can see that its amplitude has been reduced by filtering it. Instead of doing it on one channel, it's also possible if I hit edit here, I can say channel X, where X is a variable, And then I tell it the channels to do that on. So if I say 1:5, it will filter channel 1, channel 2, channel 3, channel 4, channel 5. It says channel 2 is not available, which is true, but it doesn't prevent me from doing the calculation. And then I can see all my filtered data. That's time signal calculator. Thank you.